He is so freed up.
Yes, Daddy.
I myself feel a bit gritty from the affairs
of
the day.
Oh, my God. We can do without this.
Might I dunk myself in yon Roman tub?
Not without me.
If I could get my pants off.
Marco,
you son of a bitch.
Marco.
Ginger.
Hello.
What happened?
Hello.
Ginger.
Oh, what's the matter?
It's all too much.
What is it?
I'm just feeling really vulnerable and insecure, and I think I'm getting sick. I know I'm getting a sore throat. Look, my glands are popping out. I feel feverish, and I'm just really upset, okay? I'm upset! God! Oh, I think I have to throw up. Oh, God, I just know that I don't want to have fun and hang out with the gang.
I'm sorry.
Oh, my God.
What?
I feel like your parents hate me.
No,
and
no.
I'm fat. Look at me, I'm fat. I'm a big old fat, ugly sal. Look at me, Jesus Christ, and I'm getting a pimple on my face. I'm a big old fat, ugly sal with a pimple. Are you gonna love me in 10 years when my tits are down here and I have pimples and, God, and I don't think you're attracted to me sometime. Are you attracted to me? I don't think so.
Of course I'm attracted to you. You're the sexiest woman in the world.
Well, maybe it's that you just want to fuck me. Is that it? Great. Okay, congratulations to me. Go ahead, hun. Pop it in. Do your thing. Now, come on.
For Christ's sake, what's the matter with you?
Nothing's the matter with me. What's the matter with you? Jesus, can't you be spontaneous and nasty for once? You didn't need your father's permission for that. Sometimes we rushed into this. It was all very fast. Say something. Fuck.
Isn't there a thing about them not seeing each other the night before? What?
You're still on it?
Ooh, easy, candy bar.
I dreamt I dwelt in marble halls. With vassals and serfs at my side, and of all those assembled within those walls, I was the hope and the pride. I had riches too much to count, and a high ancestral name, but I also dreamt, which pleased me most, that you loved me still, the same that you loved me. You loved me still, the same.
I just want to get some sleep, okay?
Ginger. Can I tell you something?
I wish you wouldn't.
Men without fathers are dangerous, but men with fathers like theirs are worse. They're only real when you're with them alone. And when you're not, well, they just fade away into nothing. I mean, they're like ghosts. It cost me a lot to say that. But how could you know that? You see, I was never there for either of my boys. I was always too frightened of their father. Someday,
don't just stand there. Come on in.
Why, so I can torture myself?
It was just one night, right?
It was the best night of my life.
What happened?
I'm so in love with you, Ginger. I'm so in love with you.
What are we gonna do?
Ha ha! Hey. Jack. What's going on?
Nothing. I was just, outside thinking.
Look, about Mom and Dad, they're just like an old broken record.
Yeah, I'm not thinking about Mom and Dad. I know he's a broken record.
Well, he was really out of hand today, and I'm sorry all that had
to happen. Do you love Ginger?
Excuse me?
Ginger. You love her?
Well, I'm marrying her tomorrow, I bet, right?
And she loves you.
Yeah, I think so. I mean, all relationships have their ups and downs.
You're so calm.
Have I done something to upset you?
No. You haven't done anything. You're innocent. How long have you, been going out with Ginger?
About 6 months.
I fucked her a year ago.
You fucked Ginger.
No, I didn't fuck her a year ago.
No, you didn't fuck Ginger.
No. I picked her up in a bar a year ago. And I took her home, and I... made love to her. And I think I fell in love with her, Joe. I think. I don't know, it scared the shit out of me at the time, you know, and...
Wait a minute. You think you fell in love with Ginger?
Yeah. I think it's a good thing to get it out in the open, you know what I mean?
Don't try. No, nope. I can't believe you.
Wait a minute, wow. Joe, wait a minute. I'm just trying to get this out in the open.
I know you're trying to get this out. I know you're trying to get this out. Do you mind if I have some fucking feelings about this? Huh? Or do we once again have to adjust to you because you're the sensitive rebel type?
It's all my fault. No, it's not. I ruined everything. What's going on?
I just talked to Jack. And I know what's going on now. And if you still want to get married tomorrow, I'd love that. If you don't, that's okay too. I'll go along with whatever you want. I hope you understand.
I hope you understand. I hope you understand. Joe. I try to be honest with you. I try to get things out in the open. And what happens, man? What do I get? Oh, let's just... I hope you understand he's a fucking alcoholic. Oh, I hope you understand that he's mean. Oh, I hope you understand this. I hope you understand that. I'm sick and tired of hearing that I hope you fucking understand. And now I gotta hear you say, I hope you understand. Oh, I hope you understand, Jack. We're gonna blame the whole goddamn thing on you again. Oh, I hope you fucking understand one more time. It's your goddamn fault.
What the hell is going on here?
Step, Joe.
All right,
I got it.
What? All right. What's going on? It's supposed to be a wedding in a couple of hours, you know? So, okay, thank you. What happened? Did this Tarzan, did he hit a bad load of dope or something? I want to tell you something. You have certainly picked a great guest for your wedding, you know what I mean? He's a perfect example of a fucker.
Wait a minute, Dad. I don't want you to talk about my brother like that ever again.
He's an idiot and a bastard.
I want you to pack your bags and leave my house. And I mean right now.
Wait a minute. Joe, I mean, come on, you're the... You're the only sane kid I got left. I mean, don't turn against me.
You know what, Dad? All I've ever felt for you was love. But you don't love anybody. So as far as your approval goes, I don't need it.
All right. Oh, my approval. Let's go.
Julian?
Yes, my love?
Hi. Did they get off to the airport all right?
Oh, yeah, it was perfect. We all agreed to keep in touch.
What are you doing?
Nothing.
He's looking for food.
Hey, can we eat this? I mean, you can't take it back, can you?
We can eat it.
Honey, what is this?
Well, it's got to be somebody's birthday somewhere, right? Those are like little candies when they're being together.
Same thing with your partial tart.
Little red hots.
Just for you, Daddy. Just for you.
Thank you. These were hers.
Let me get this straight. She just left. She didn't say anything?
She said, quote unquote,
I can't take this anymore.
I know. I know. I'm sorry.
Would you stop saying you're sorry? Look, I know you're sorry, but it doesn't help anything.
I've been trying everything I can. Do you have any idea how many people are out there trying to do what I'm doing?
I know, but I need you to get a regular job.
Stephanie, I thought you understood. I have to stay available for auditions.
I've understood long enough.
Any day, something's gonna happen for me. Something incredible.
Shit.
Where are you going?
I have to get out of here. I have to breathe.
What does that mean? What does that mean, Steph?
Look, Charlie, I love you, but I can't be with you right now. You need to learn to take care of yourself. Grow up a bit.
Wait, don't go. Stephanie, I'll find a job, I swear it. Steph?
Charlie, you've got to get a hold of yourself.
I can't live here anymore.
That's what I've been trying to tell you. I mean, how much is the rent on a place like this anyway? It's an honest question.
You shouldn't be talking about money at a time like this. Look at how badly he's suffering.
Look, relationships here are like a tornado. You know, they start with a lot of sucking and blowing, but eventually you end up losing your house.
What are you talking about?
It's just a fact.
We collected these on our 13th month anniversary, June 15, 1992.
Charlie, honey, maybe she was right. Maybe it's time for another career choice.
I'm the only one that stuck it out all these years. Like, doesn't that mean anything to you?
There comes a point in a man's life when he gets tired of eating macaroni and cheese 6 nights a week. See?
Steph was a great cook.
Hey.
For Christ's sakes, be careful. She found this in the backyard.
Charlie?
She was so gentle. She carried it in here.
What's going on? I mean, whether she's here or not, this place is like a fucking museum, man.
What did you say?
I said you're crazy and you need some sleep. The next thing you know, you'll be charging us admission to come over.
Come on. Maybe you could call it performance art. I mean, does that help?
No.
Hey, look, why didn't you sleep on it?
Don't say a word. Not a word. Don't tell me anything about her. I want to feel the life through the artifacts. I can't imagine what you're going through. You, the single twinkling light in the vast planetarium of pain. I'm sorry. Catherine Price from the State Historical Society. Friends call me Kitty. May I ask how long she's been gone?
4 days.
And still no word? Oh, you poor thing. She's gone, though. And the sooner you start dealing with that, the sooner you're gonna start to live.
Yeah, well, look, that's what I've been trying to do. I mean, 3 curators have been by already and not...
And not one of them could grasp your concept.
Not only did they not grasp it, but they ran out of here as though I were insane.
Well, you're dealing with a very exciting and explosive idea. And very few people could handle it. They think of museums as these big buildings made out of concrete, filled with objets d'art, open to the public. But that's actually a relatively new phenomenon, only in the past 200 years. Before that, collections of things were done by private individuals. Wartime was always good for that. Is that one of the few fragile reminders of the embers that still burn within you?
It's a bird's nest. Steph found it out the backyard one day.
And she brought it inside. Why do you think she did that?
Because it looks nice.
It's a power object. Architecture that would exist even if we weren't here. A vessel, a home. A place to raise babies and watch them fly away.
Ah, Steph.
No. Don't do that. These are very priceless to us now, these objects.
You really think that it's a great idea, that it has potential?
Potential? It's a curatorial dream come true. It's what I've been looking for. Tell me about your idea. I want to feel the passion of your vision.
Okay. Well, it's the history of a doomed romance.
I love it. Go on.
Well, I was chatting to some friends, and it hit me like a ton of bricks.
What hit you? Tell me.
Make this place something special. You know, take this bad moment in my life and turn it around. Make it something positive. A living, breathing museum with the lover left behind.
It's a brilliant concept, Charlie. It can put me on the map of the curatorial world. I can't wait to get started. I think we were destined to meet, Charlie. Destined to become collaborators.
I love you.
I think we better get going.
Kitty, I didn't hear you come in.
Stop! Charlie, don't brush away your tears. Let them flow. You mustn't hide your passion from me, darling.
I'm not so sure I can go through with this. It's so hard. Everywhere I look, I see her.
Silly, Charlie. I understand. I know what you're going through. But we're gonna make it all better. I mean, watching movies of the two of you in happier times is bound to bring up some deep emotional response. Pain, loss. But as an actor, you must know that to reach the highest achievement in your art, you must begin to plummet the deepest depths of your soul. And I know you're capable of that, Charlie. I have total and absolute faith in you. No, don't wipe them away. Give them meaning. Your tears have so much value to us now. Okay, Charlie, we have a lot to accomplish this morning. Let's get started with the closet, shall we? Look at this. I wonder where she got it. There's got to be a story behind a dress like this.
Actually, that's the dress Steph wore on our first date. Kitty, I'm not so sure I feel comfortable having you go through things.
Charlie, this is my job. I know what I'm doing. These are very valuable ingredients. If you withhold from your creation, you're just limiting your expression.
I don't know, Kitty. Okay.
Good. And we'll make its own display case with a little plaque that reads, the dress she was to be married in.
Married?
It's just a slight exaggeration, just for dramatic effect.
Right.
Charlie Baker.
Yes?
How are you doing today?
Yeah,
Good. We'll be reading from the script. Let's do Act 1, Scene 8, page 37. Starting at the top of the page, please.
37 from the top?
37, starting at the top of the page, please.
Okay. Goodbye to you. Now I am alone. Oh, what a rogue and peasant slave am I. Is it not monstrous that this player here, but in a fiction, in a dream of passion, should force his soul so to his own conceit, that from her working all his visage waned, and all for nothing, for Hecuba? What is Hecuba to him and he to Hecuba that he should weep for her? And what would he do had he the motive and the cue for passion that I have? And yet I, a dull and muddy-mettled rascal, peak like John o' Dreams, unpregnant of my cause, and can say nothing. No, not for a king upon whose property and dear life a damned defeat was made. Am I a coward?
I got some big news.
What?
I got a job today.
Yeah?
Hamlet. I'm gonna play Hamlet.
Yes!
Well, I've got some great news too, sweetheart.
Yeah? What?
Well, from now on, the State Historical Society is going to be paying your rent.
$1,500? I mean, this is amazing.
They loved it. Historic house concept, changing social patterns, emotional resonance of our era. Plus, Grandpa founded the Historical Society.
I can't believe it. It's great.
Well, they want to do 3 tours a day with me conducting them. Tuesday through Saturday, 1.5 hours per tour. Charlie, it's the role of a lifetime.
What do you mean?
Well, you have to be involved. Scorn Lover Left Behind. That's how I sold it to them. You and me making our mark on the world.
But what about the play?
Charlie, stop and think about it for a second. This role you've been offered?
Yeah, Hamlet.
Yes, yes. Why recreate something when you can produce something new, something fresh?
What?
Our museum may well be the Hamlet of the 20th century.
What are you talking about?
Study the great painters, Picasso, Rembrandt. They redefined the form. They didn't dabble around in what already existed.
I can't turn down an acting job, Kitty. I just can't.
Charlie, I'm not asking you to turn down anything. Stop and think about it for a minute. This could be a whole new approach to acting. You don't understand the grandeur of your vision. Life imitating art instead of art imitating life. You've been waiting for the masterwork of your career. And this is it. With you as the creator, we can't go wrong.
Things in Denmark, old boy, still rotten.
Charles.
Yeah, what? I'm sorry.
Hamlet, Dave said you were going to be playing the Dane. Congratulations.
Oh, well, not anymore.
What happened?
They didn't fire you, did they?
Mitchell.
It's an honest question.
No, nothing like that. Actually, I figured, why recreate something when you can produce something completely new and fresh?
Mm-hmm.
I fought for weeks to get you an audition, and you turn it down?
Dave, we're creating the Hamlet of the 20th century.
You're doing all the creating, darling. I just took a diamond in the rough and polished it up so it'd shine in the light.
Nobody in their right mind turns down Hamlet, Charlie.
Yeah, that's like getting elected president and turning it down to manage a tasty freeze.
I know you guys are finding it hard to understand, but I just don't want to dabble in what already exists.
Hello. Since when is playing one of the greatest roles in the English-speaking theater dabbling?
You study the great painters, Picasso, Rembrandt. They all redefine the form.
As your agent, I have to say you're not making any sense, Charlie. I mean, what exactly are you redefining here?
Listen, why don't you come on Saturday, okay? We're having a special preview tour. Come on Saturday, and I can show you what it is I'm talking about. You guys are gonna love it.
Imagine, if you will, the opening day of the Louvre. What the people must have felt, what they beheld. Well, today, you lucky people get to be the first to experience a new phenomena, a museum of love. A bird's nest, yes, but also a power object. Architecture that would be here even if we weren't. At the Benedictine Monastery at Vendôme in France, they own a vial containing a single tear wept by Jesus at the death of Lazarus. Here we have a vial containing a tear wept by Charlie when Stephanie broke his heart. This is her scent, her essence, that haunts Charlie every day of his life. A lock of Stephanie's lustrous hair, lovingly tied. Right this way, to the room where they share their ideas of love and marriage. At the Peace Museum in Hiroshima stands a clock, stopped at 8:15, the time of the bomb blast. Just like this house, everything as it was. A living memorial to a shattered love affair. Emotional fallout on every doorknob, on every windowsill. Belongings untouched. But to really grasp the intensity of the young man's emotions, we must descend into the depths of the museum. One man's response to deep misery and pain. He was to be married in the fall, but instead she trampled on his heart, leaving him behind without a warning.
Stephanie! Stephanie, my heart. It's breaking, Steph. It's breaking. Hey, Ron. Where's Mitch and Dave?
They left.
Oh, that's bad. Did they hate it? I thought it went pretty well. What'd you think?
I didn't know that you and Steph were gonna get married.
Yeah, well, we magnified the situation to get the most emotional impact.
She hung in there with you for a lot of lean years, Charlie. Don't forget that.
She left me, Ron. She trampled on my heart, left me without any warning.
Stop it, Charlie. You're beginning to sound like that woman in there.
Who, Kitty?
Yeah, she's crazy. Can't you see that? I mean, she's on the train to Looneyville, and you're the conductor.
I'm just dealing with my demons and making some money all at the same time.
She's brainwashed you.
She has not. This is what I've always dreamed of.
A what? To hang out in your basement clutching your ex-girlfriend's lingerie? Wake up, Charlie.
It was my idea, Ron. People didn't understand Picasso either.
Charlie, grow up. You're trapped in your past.
Charlie?
Stephanie? Is that you?
Ron called me, told me what's going on.
Ah, Ron, right. He was kind of upset.
So am I.
Really?
Yes. What is all this?
It's my museum. Our museum. You and I, our love.
This is what you've been doing since I've been gone. My God, Charlie, what are you thinking?
Well, when you left me, I didn't know what to do. I got inspired.
You're turning our relationship into a display case for everyone to see is not what I meant when I said I need you to get a job.
But it's a great thing. I mean, people love it.
It's not a great thing, Charlie. Can't you see that you're obsessed?